wellness. That's incredible. That blows my mind that how can somebody be so almighty and so powerful yet be a loving God? You know, the other day in Tracy, it poured. I don't know if it did it rain here a couple days ago. Not that much. In Tracy, I thought like I was going to build an ark. I was this close. An angel, let's build an ark, man. I don't know. It was pouring. And then it started thunder and lightning. And it was this, there was one, you know how you see the lightning, you count the seconds to see how far when the thunder comes, that's how close it is to you. Well, this one lightning was like, it sounded like the sky ripped in half. It just lit up, and then a half a second later, it just sounded like it ripped the sky. And I was like, wow. And then I thought of something. I thought of Jesus and the book with the apostles, and they're all scared. And the waves are tossing them to and fro, and there's thunder, and there's lightning, and there's rain, and they wake up Jesus. And Jesus says, oh, you of little faith. And he commands the storm to stop. And I was just thinking, I was hearing that thunder, I was seeing the lightning and the downpour, it was pouring. And I was like, what would it be like to stand out there and just say, stop, and it stopped. We serve a mighty God. That's incredible. For Jesus to get up, he's in a boat, he's asleep, he gets up, kind of wiping his eyes. I imagine he's like, oh man, you guys, really? Oh man, storm, stop. Boat stops. That's incredible. The apostles were like, who is this man that even the weather obeys him? That's the one we serve. That's the Almighty God. That is the one that we serve and celebrate. Amen. Because he's all powerful and mighty. But in the moment that Joshua needed a victory to step out and say, God, I need you to do something for me now. It did not require for Joshua to completely understand everything that was going on around him. Neither did it need a perfect prayer to be uttered with all these fancy words for God to come through in his behalf. So I'm asking you this morning, we're celebrating Jesus. And you can sit here and say, yeah, but. Yeah, but you don't know what I'm going through. Yeah, but you don't know my struggle. Yeah, but you don't know my marriage. Yeah, but you don't know what the doctor told me. Yes, but you don't know what my son did. You don't know what my daughter did. You don't know what my husband did. You don't know what my parents did to me. You don't know what happened to me. I want to celebrate, but I don't know how. Perfect place. Joshua said, son, stand still. Here's the key to all of this. God understood that what Joshua said was backwards. But did he not do what he asked him? Did the sun not stand still? Did the moon not stand in its place? Because the scripture says that it did. And they had victory. Why? Because Joshua knew what he was asking for? No. Because Joshua knew who to ask for. God, I need you right now. Close your eyes right now in this moment.